I have something today that is not easy. It's difficult. But so many people this past week have contacted me to say, Deacon, are you or his father going to say something about the new round of sex abuse in our church? Or are we going to leave Mass on Sunday wondering if the church is going to say something? So I feel what is best to say is what our leadership says. And I share with you a letter that came out on Friday morning from Archbishop Bastecki. And here is what the Archbishop shares with us. Dear brothers and sisters, just 2 weeks ago, I wrote about the scandal surrounding former Cardinal Theodore McCarrick about clergy sexual abuse. Now I find myself once again reflecting upon the horrible news coming from the grand jury reports from the diocese in Pennsylvania. As a church, we have made and continue to make progress in addressing clergy sexual abuse of minors and holding perpetrators accountable. Then this news hits, and we are reminded of just how terrible things were and how the stain of this sin remains with us today. Each media report picks open a scab. While my heart aches for victims as they are forced to relive their own experiences, I'm grateful for their courage in telling their stories. As I wrote a couple of weeks ago, we have implemented policies in this archdiocese, along with checks and balances, including with the input and oversight of both our Community Advisory Board and Diocesan Review Board. However, our archdiocese is not immune today because of the work that's been done in the past or the progress that has been made. We must remain vigilant in our commitment to keep children safe and hold perpetrators accountable. We must be watchful and attentive to how the imbalance of power affects these abusive relationships. Let me again urge anyone who has experienced sexual abuse by anyone in the church to come forward. Reports can be made to our Archdiocese Victim Assistance Coordinator, or contact can be made with local law enforcement. So as we gather, let us together pray for our church, for those who have experienced the pain and suffering of abuse in any way. May the Holy Spirit give us wisdom. May we always learn from the sins of the past and do everything in our power to ensure those sins that they not be repeated. With assurance of prayers, I am sincerely yours in Christ, Most Reverend Jerome E. Lestecki, Archbishop of Milwaukee. So we have to deal with this. We are the church. We are the ones that need to help bring about the change. It begins with admitting it. It continues with asking for forgiveness. We have to ask for forgiveness because we are the church. So let us pray for those who the Archbishop asked us to pray for. I ask that we also pray for the Archbishop. This is a very difficult thing for him to face. And as Christ taught us that we have to pray for our enemies, I ask we include in our prayers the perpetrators themselves. They are still God's children. They must be facing terrible, terrible trauma, those who still live. These latest abuses come from as long ago as 70 years ago, from 1947. So let us pray and trust the Spirit in God that out of this difficult time we'll be made stronger as we continue to support those who need our support. Let's celebrate now as we celebrate the Eucharist and celebrate Mass.